Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel once again. And you know, in the last video tutorial, we created the signup page. The signing page. So basically, what we're going to do today is to just create the signup page. So when you click on the signup, if you don't have the account, and then you click on the signup, it should take you just to the signup page. And also, we will do look at how we can add symbols to our Flutter application. For example, you see we have, this is the price of the food item, but we can also decide to add the currency symbol to the price of the food we have here. So basically that's what we are going to do today. So we'll start with the sign up page. So I'll just go into my pages folder and then create a new sign up underscore page on page dot dot. So what I'll do, I'll just copy this whole and here, copy the whole sign in page and then paste it here, because that's exactly what we are going to do. And we'll just change something. So first let's change this from sign up, then make it sign up page. It is, and then we paste this one here. Oh, I paste it twice, and then we also have to change this side. Okay, we have to change this side too, and then we can copy this one and then paste it here. So now we have our sign up page, which looks exactly like the sign in page. So I'll go to my sign in here, and then in this sign in where we have the sign up, let me just find it. Sign up. Yeah. So here's the sign up. When you click on this one, this sign up test here is here. So we have to sign. First, let me just format this whole thing. String. Okay. Yeah. So now we can wrap the test widget with a guest editor, or we can use an inkwell, or yeah. So anyone we want to use, so I'll just click here and then use wrap with a new widget. I think I'll use a Twitter, because I don't want that ripple effect when you click on it. But if you want the ripple effect, then you can use an inkwell, and you can also call the on tap on both. So just do that. Then I'll come out here. So what we want to do is that when you click on the sign up, it will take you to that page. So you can just go ahead and enter that contest dot push. This time I'm going to use push replacement, because when you click on the sign up page, I want to replace the sign in, the current contest, which is the sign in, with the sign up page, instead of creating a new route for the sign up page. The reason is, if someone is on the sign up page and then the person click on the back button, it will take the person back to the signing page, and I don't want that way, because on the sign up page I also have a link. I will have a link that will also take the user back to the signing page. So I'm gonna use the push replacement, which will replace the signing page with the the sign up page using the same route. I hope you just get what I mean. Material page route here, and we can set a builder. Then we set audio contest here, and then we can just go ahead and then create a sign up page. So, that is imported automatically. I showed you in the last tutorial. So this one is here. So if you don't have it, you can import it. So you can import it this way, or you can just import it by removing this whole thing. I think this way here. So you can import it this way, or if you have the auto import, that's okay. So we have our sign up page connected here. So when I save, and now when I click on this, it should take me to the, okay, basically it's to the sign in page. But anyway, let me just go back. See, let me just go to the proceed to checkout. It will take me to the sign in page. So let's go to our sign up page here, and then let's make the changes that we have to make. So here we sign up, right? Sign up. Let me go to the sign up. So yeah, we have the sign up here. Now when I click to the backspace here, just put it will take me back to the proceed to checkout. And that's exactly what I want, because that's why I use the push replacement. So when you click on the proceed and then you click on the sign up, it replaces the sign in with the sign up on the same route. So it doesn't create another route and then open the sign up page there. So we can just go ahead, and in this sign up you don't want a forgotten password. So let's find the forgotten password here. And this is the rule for the forgotten password. I don't need it. So I will just take this one off from here, and then let's save it. Okay, now we don't have it. So what we need here is we need username, email, and then password, and then confirm password basically. So when the person sign up later, the person can add other details like first name or last name. And we will also figure out, I will ask you, I don't know, you guys can tell me the information you want to take from the user. You see, the first application, the food app I did was for student. So what I was taking details of student, but in this one, I think we are not just going to do it for school, so we can take different details in this application. But then here we'll just take the first, the username, email, and then password, and then later we can think about what we want, the information we want to accept from the user. So let's just go here and then just copy this one. Yeah, copy this one and then paste here. And then this one we can change one to be the user. So we can change here to be user name test field, and then we can say username here, and then here will be email, right? You get a point. Here will be email, and then we can also copy the password field just here. Password field here, and then we can also say build confirm password. Oh, I didn't explain that. Let me just go here. Confirm password. So we have our confirmed password, username, and then email. So we can just add it. We're going to our help. Yeah. So we can just add it here. So first we want our build username test field, and then we can put our size was there. And also we can after the email we want the password, and then we want the confirmed password. So we can put this same thing here, and then we can build confirm password here. So when we save, I think we should have something here. So we have our email, username, email, and then password, but we want this one to be confirmed password. And let me show you something here. Okay, we will fix this error later, but let me just let's just fix the error. Let me just take this off. But what I wanted to show you is that when you click here, it will affect both the password and then confirm password. There's nothing here, but let me just type something there. Then bring this one down. Bring this one down. And here you see it's affecting because we are using the same variable for that. So let's just go up here. Where's the confirm password here? And here we want confirm password. Yeah. And then we can't use the same variable for here, so I'll just say toggle confirm visibility here, and then do the same for this side, and then the same for this side. We are just copy this one. and then paste it here. Paste it here. Which side again? And then when we come here, we also have to create a variable for the confirm. Yeah, so we have that one fixed. And now when I save and I click here, it doesn't affect the other one. And when I click here, it doesn't affect this one too. So we have that one fixed. And you see, we are having an error when you try to type something here. And then we can just fix this by going into our scaleful widget. Where is the scaleful widget? Yeah. When we come into our scaleful widget, there's an argument that we can pass, and that's resize to avoid bottom padding. So we can say false for now, and then when we save, we shouldn't have that error. But we don't have that error. I mean, that error there, but I think that's okay for now. Let's just reduce the space here. The padding. I mean, let me sign up. You can find it. Signup. Yeah. Here we have. We just reduce this to 50. Yeah, I think that's okay. And we also have to change the button from. Let me just go to find sign in. Oh, sorry. Find sign in. Yeah. So we have this sign in here. We don't want that one. Yeah, I mean, but we want to change it to sign up instead of sign in. Just make this one popular. And then we have that one sign in. And then we have to change the information here. So we can say already have an account here. Already have an account, and then we can then change this one to sign in. Sign in here. Let me just make this one copy. Yeah. So let me just format. If you don't know how to format, there's one guy in my I think Richard Dankwa showed me how to format our code in Visual Studio. So it's just Shift Alt and then F. So if you're wondering how I was doing it, it's just Shift Alt F. You press all together, and then just Shift Alt F, and it will format all your code. I mean, it will just beautify your code for you. Okay, so we have our sign up page, and now we have to also link this one to the sign in page. So here we just do the same for them. Just rub this one with a new widget, and we are just going to do the same. Gesture detector, and we can just go ahead and create it on top. And we can all, we are just doing the same. I feel like copying the same code from that place because I don't tap. Tab plenty, so I just copy this side and then come here. Just clear this one and then paste it there. And then we have to just remove this one. Say sign in page here. So sign in page, and this automatically imported my sign in page. So sorry. Okay, I don't know what just happened, but anyway, so I have my sign in page imported. So guys, let's just save and then click on the sign. So now we have this. When we click here, we also have our sign in page. So we are just using push replacement. So when I click on the back button, it should take me to this page, and that's exactly what I want. I don't want it to take me back to, that's why I was using the push replacement. So there's one thing I also want to do in this tutorial, as I mentioned earlier. When you go to the other card here, you see we have this price, and we want to add symbols like the dollar sign or any currency symbol that you have. And first, in Flutter, I mean, in that, that allows you to insert symbols. It allows you to insert symbols by a concept called rooms. So rooms just allow you to enter a Unicode character, I mean, a Unicode for your symbols. So when you go to Google, I mean, this particular website here, you can get all symbols and their Unicode. You see, we just visit this website here. The link is here. Okay, I'll leave the link in the comment, I mean, the description below. And then you can look for any symbol here, and then you can just use this the character code to insert any symbol in Flutter. So I'm a Ghanaian, and then this is our our currency symbol. So if you hover your mouse on the symbol, you can see we have 023B here. So when I go to this, here's the price, I mean, for our food item here. So when I come here, I can just use the escape character here, and I can just add 023B here. And when I save, you see the character here, I mean, the currency here. So basically, that's how you can add any symbol. Let's just look at other symbols. Where's the dollar sign? I'm just trying to look for the dollar sign, but you can add any symbol that you want. I can't find it, but I just go ahead and add any symbol. So I'll add this one, this 01FE. So when we come here, we can just say 01FE. So let's just save and see what we get. And you can see that symbol there, right? So basically, that's how you can add symbols to in Flutter application or in that. So you just use the escape character /u, and then you add the character code here, I mean the Unicode. So guys, thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video tutorial.